new, welcome. And if you aren't, what's up? And so, in today's video, I will be showing you all how I got these straight back feeders on myself. And if you would like to see how to do straight back feeders on yourself, then keep on watching.
Focus on me, babe. You don't have to let nobody fuck with our vibe. Love all on me, babe.
So, I am just detangling my hair. I had a, like a slick back curly ponytail. So I am just going in, detangling my hair. I had hella gel on my hair. So I am just detangling it. And after detangling it, I am going to actually go wash up. So I'm gonna go shower, brush my teeth, brush my face, all that good stuff. And then I'm gonna come back when it's like time to blow dry and all that good stuff. So y'all just about to watch me detangle my hair. And I got so much growth. Like, y'all see how short my hair was in the beginning of the year? And then looking at it now, like, yeah, I grew my own hair. Like, I really grew my own. All I use is this oil, which y'all gonna see me oil my scalp with it after I blow dry my hair. And this is my own oil, like my own little concoction. Like, I made this oil, like. Just detangle my hair. The goal is, with my hair length, I want. And my hair is so thick, I really gotta make sure I detangle, like, go in and detangle extra little sides and parts. And I clipped my ends. I clipped my ends so I could get some more growth going. So, yeah. I think it's pretty much, no, it's not. You always want to detangle your hair before you wash it and, like, do the detangling with the deep conditioner or just conditioning it, period. Just detangle your hair before washing it because it's going to cut down on how much shedding you actually have. Your hair naturally sheds. So when you comb out your hair and you got, like, this is, like, how much shedding I got, and that's normal. But don't be like raking your shit. Like, don't do that. Like, don't do that. So I am detangled. So I'm about to go boom, 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 and I will be back. Okay, so I am showered and fresh. Is freshly washed. It's a little damp, so when my hair is like this, I like to go in with my oil. This is the oil I'm using, but this ain't.
Go ask your uncle for something. Okay, I'm working right now.
this is not just wild growth oil. This is my little concoction of oils. I'm not gonna say what's inside of it, but it's a bunch of different oils, and this is the only thing that I put on my hair. Natural style, when I'm doing the protective style and I need to oil my scalp, this is the only thing that I put on me and my son here. So I'm about to just oil my hair. And for me, I don't really like, I focus it more so on my ends and my edges because I tend to do, not all the time, but I do like to do, wear wigs and stuff like that. And I just want to make sure that I don't become bald head at the edges and the back of my hair, because sometimes I do like the wig where you can put it at the back. Full lace wigs, whatever you call it. So after that, I just go in, put it on my scalp, just like so. And then I put some in my hands. Put some in my hands. And I can go like this. Disclaimer. Don't talk about this little, you know what I'm saying, right here, because it is a thick ass pimple that I had. You know, I had it for like a week or whatever. If you watch my it was my Mother's Day vlog and the makeup look that I had did, the little creative look with the J-Lo little pigments, you will see it in both of those videos. And it actually started like right before I had did. It wasn't as big though. I had did that makeup look, and then like it's springtime or whatever. So because of that, like my allergies start messing up. My skin is already sensitive. So I'm constantly breaking out. So it's been like 2-3 weeks straight. I have been doing nothing but facials. I also got a facial routine up on my channel as well. You go watch that. But anywho, I had did that makeup look, and it got bigger. And then, like a dumbass, I was like, oh, I'm about to do my makeup for Mother's Day. And I did a face beat. It wasn't no major face beat. It was something simple, something slight. But that made it even bigger. And I'm talking about big to the point where, like, if I, like, did this, like, look down, I probably just look hella crazy. But, like, if I look down, like, right now, I can't see this because it's flat. It look like, you know, like a bump or something, but it's not. It's just flat. That's the scar that the pimple left, but it was so big that when I looked down, I could literally see it like protruding out my skin. So I popped that motherfucker. Yes, I did. I popped it. I usually do not pop my pimples. I do my facials, and that's how they go away. But not that one. That one just kept getting bigger. Like, usually when I pop my pimples, this is so off subject, but I don't care. Usually when I pop my pimples, I take like a hot, like a clean hot towel, like hot, like I run it under my water while it's real hot. And my water, if you've been to my house, my water gets hot, like burned to the touch, like you will damn near get third degree burned just from my faucet water. That's how hot it gets. So I usually do that. I didn't do that. I was just so tired of that pimple being there, I just started fucking with it. And I was going at it like from different sides, like, you feel me? it wouldn't pop. So again, I put the tail right there. The hot tail, when you pop in your pimples or your little zits or whatever, please, 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 please use a hot rag and press it, you know, on it and hold it there, because it's gonna loosen it up. And then when you pop it, it's like, it's not gonna hurt as much. My dumb ass, I did it, but I didn't do it long enough. I was just so tired of that pimple being there. I just popped it. It was so much in there, like it literally like shot out. It was nasty, but I popped it. But it was hurting too much the night I did it, so I just stopped. I just did a little facial routine and went to bed. But the morning after, hell no. I literally ended up part two of draining the motherfucking pimple. I ended up draining it again. I ended up getting all of it out, but this is what it ended up leaving. And it's actually going down. It was actually bigger than that. Like it was like all right here. It was huge, the scar that it left. But it's going down. I need to quit touching it because I like to pick at my scars. And I don't want to do that and then it leave like a permanent scar right there. But yes, don't come for this because it looked like I got my ass beat, but period. Mm-hmm. I'll take no ill. Damn, I shut up love this shit. Okay. So for this style, you will need rat tail comb for your parting. I usually keep two different like combs or whatever. Edge control brush for your edges. Clips. Gem for your parting and like making a braid meet or whatever. This is the brand of gem that I use. If you can see it, it's the shiny gem and it's the red one. I usually use this one or the orange one, and that's the one, not the black gem with the orange top, because that gem is like a greenish color and that is not good for holding hair. It looks just like this, but it's all orange, and I use that one. Or this, you will need, of course, edge control, a mousse, and a hairspray. And I really like using these two. Of course, it's in the same set with the jam. I usually use pump it up spritz too, but I ran out. So you will need pump it up spritz or a spritz, just a spritz period. Because when you put the jam on, the spritz like holds everything into place. Then you put the mousse on. The mousse is like another additive to holding everything into place. And then the hairspray is the final step. You will also need some wig strips. They are all the way over there, so on the side of my dresser. But y'all will see me put them on in the video. And then you will also need your braiding hair. I am using two different types of braiding hair, so I don't have enough of this color because this is my, you know, my natural, imagine my natural hair color. But I have some extra packs of red hair, and I'm not going to get into why I have this red hair. It was bought for no reason in the first fucking place, but we going to put it to use today. So basically what I'm going to do is, all of my braids are going to start out, I would say, all of my braids, I'll say like from here to probably like halfway, are going to be this color. And then I'm going to transition the braid into the red hair. So the red hair is going to be all the way down. So, I'm going to basically walk y'all through the parting. I'm going to do like my first braid on camera. I'm probably going to go off camera and do the rest just because I have to be very, very focused. So, I'm going to do like my first braid on camera. I'm going to do my parting, show y'all the party, and do my first braid on camera. camera. I'm gonna come back when I have like a good amount done, and then I'm gonna show y'all, you know, other braid, and then come back when I have them all done. That's how I'm about to do this. So this part is, I don't know if I'm gonna fast forward. So if I fast forward, y'all will see me fast forward. If I keep talking, I keep talking. So we about to part, and I don't feel like getting back up to get my wide tooth comb. So we just gonna use this wig brush to like really make sure it's no tangles or nothing like that in the hair. I got so much hair. Like, am I really about to sit here and fucking do small feeders? Yes, I am, because they're really cute, and that's what I want to do. So we are going to start parting.
Okay, so this is where the voiceover is going to start. I am just parting my hair, and I am using my mirror. You will see me constantly go back and forth between using my mirror to help make sure that my part is straight. I have two mirrors, so one in front of me and then the smaller mirror from my bathroom, which is what I use to help me part the back of my hair. I take that jam that you saw me use, the red one, and that is what I use to put on my part to help get a clean part. I am using that to put on my part, like I said. I'm using two different kinds of braiding hair. One is brown, which is like closer to my natural tone of hair, and then the red, which I will use halfway through the braid all the way down to the ends of the braid. Like I said, I am taking that mirror and just helping see what the part is looking like and if I need to go in and straighten up my part. So to do my feeders, like you see me doing, I'm taking that jam, putting it on my part, and just combing it through. That's nasty, but I'm not about to restart this voice recording because this is like the third time I'd have tried to do this voiceover, so we just gonna keep going. So now I'm just braiding, and I braid about like 3-4 times back, and then I grab a piece of hair. Now when I grab the hair, I leave one part out, and the other part I braid in. And then when I get back to that piece that's laying out, I grab that and braid that in. So I grabbed another piece of hair, I left one part out, braided the other. And then when I got back to the other side where the piece was left out at, then I braid that in. I didn't like how that braid was looking, so I started over. But the technique that this is called the 1-2 method, I believe, where you grab one piece of hair, but you are braiding them in at that piece of hair at two different times. I believe that's how you describe it, but it's easier to watch me do it than me to try to verbally explain it. And it's kind of easier for me to, like, I'm a hands-on person, which a lot of people are hands-on people. So I would have to, like, you know, physically show you what I am doing. But that's what I'm doing. And then when I get halfway through that braid, I'm going to take the red hair, and I'm going to start the red hair. So I'm going to be doing, I started this one braid.
So I'm going to do this entire braid on camera. And then the next clip, I'm going to have like a good amount of that section braided. In total, I believe I did about 20 or I think like 18 to 20 braids on my head. And I mean, they look decent. It's just, you know, it's always room for improvement. And I know one thing I have to work on when I do hair on myself is my parting. But when I do hair on my clients, they look bomb AF. I'm trying to stop cussing, and I'm pretty sure I done cussed a couple of times before now. But so now I am at the end of the braid, and I am just braiding it down. I wanted them to come to my butt like a little bit past my butt. So when I get like halfway, like right now, you see me adding in another piece of red braiding here. And that is, I'm just going to braid that all the way down. So that is how I do my feeders. This is how I do bigger feeders. This is how, you know, a feeder is a feeder. It doesn't matter what size the braid is, but yes. So that is one braid done out of 17 more braids that I have to do. So I believe the next clip I had like a good majority of the side done. But that damn scar on my face just look, no. And one thing I don't like about braiding hair is it gets every fucking wear, like everywhere. So that is that one braid done. So as you can see, I got a good amount of that section braided down. So now I'm going to be showing you all the braid again, just so that you can get a good, so that you can really see how I did the braid. So I'm just brushing it out, making sure that it is fully detangled, because my hair, even though it is detangled, it will still tangle with it being in that state. I said tangle. I meant detangle. Even though it's detangled, it will still end up getting tangled with it being in that state. And I ain't even gonna hold y'all. I took like 2 days to do this because I was just on some lazy shit. But it really wasn't even me being on some lazy shit. It was this medicine that I be taking. And I gotta make sure I'm not doing anything when I take this medication, because it will knock me out. Like, and I will literally be knocked for like hours. So that's kind of a reason why it took me 2 days to do that braid, these braids. So like I said, I'm going to start off braiding it. I braid it back like about 3 to 4 times. And then, like you can see right now, I'm braiding it back, braiding it back, braiding it back, braiding it back, braiding it back. Braiding it back. It's just to see how thick it starts to get. And then that's when I take a piece of the braiding hair and add it in. Now you can see me doing that method. Braid one piece back. When I get back to my right index, or is that my left index finger? When I get back to my left index finger, that's when I add that piece of hair that was hanging out in. And then I also add in another piece of hair. And this is just for me to get the thickness of the braid that I want it to be. And then once I have the desired thickness, then I stop adding in hair. I had messed up on a couple of them, like on the left side of my head. One or two of them was a little thicker than I had planned on braiding them to be. So yeah. Now I'm adding in that red hair, and I'm just going to do the same thing until I get the desired thickness that I want for that braid. So yeah, that is how, basically it's kind of like self-explanatory. That's how I got this this braided style. So yeah, you can just keep watching me braid. I think I braided this all the way down, and then
hold on, Holiday. You can't give it to them dry like that. You gotta get that shit wet first, nigga. Like, come on now. You gotta prep them for shit like that. They can't just get that shit right off the top. Like, you gotta bring that shit back. Bring that shit the fuck back.
Holiday season. Hey, I think we got your attention by there, right? Holiday season.
You was fucking a Yankee. I was fucking with Bass. I was pitching to Frankie. These bitches so cranky. Give them a hanky. My mommy, I'm cold. Give me my blankie. Flyer than a kite. I get higher than Rapunzel. Keep the snow white. I could buy it by the bundle. Set your cookies up before they come.
Okay. So, that was the braid.
Mm-hmm.
And my hair is done. Y'all want to see? I'm gonna try to do this transition and hopefully I do it right. So I'm gonna and like snatch it off, like boom, and then when I turn back, but when I turn back around, you'll see my whole little shebang. So like hopefully I'll do it right. So I'm about to try to do it. I got something in my eye. So, why am I doing my arm like that? Okay, boom, I'm trying to do it again. Okay.
So, in the process of me editing, I deleted the next clip for the transition. So, I then tried to go back into my photos and recover that video so that I could edit it. And I deleted the video. So this is what my hair is looking like. My edges is not done no more. My makeup ain't done no more. Nothing ain't done no more. Although I am highly, highly irritated, which is going to keep flowing. So this concludes the end of my tutorial. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. Comment, share, and subscribe to my channel, and I will catch you in my next video.